Howdy folks, and welcome back once more. Let's play Commander Keen! Today, we're going to the Brownian Motion Inducer. Oh, this looks like some oh no. Oh, I am markedly displeased by this. Ooh, ain't shit! Alright, well, we can come down here, and as long as I don't jump, we're okay. Okay, pretty reasonable. Was that a killbot? No, just one of these little dudes. Alright. See, they're giving me, like, a shitload of ammo and stuff, and a bunch of the extra life things, extra life bottles. Mildly worrying. Oh, I'll wait. Okay, alright. See, there's a door up there. Alright. See what we got over here. Oh, wait. Oh, can I shoot up? I can. Nice. Okay, so that door has a symbol next to it. Oh, shit. Ooh! That door also has a symbol to it. Seriously, God, oh my lord! One job, I just need to kill one thing. Okay, so, alright, so... Okay... I'm gonna save, because if I had to guess, that thing sticking out of the wall will kill me if I touch it, and I would rather not lose what little progress we've made. Can we jump on it? Yes, okay, and those things were worth 5,000 points. So that's pretty hot. Can we drop down? Yes. Alright, so we have doors up there. I'm gonna have to figure. I'm sure that there's a puzzle involving going through them in a correct order or something. Oh. Oh. Oh, that's terrible down there. Alright. I'm thankful that they let me look before I leap. There's a secret right here of some sort. Alright, there were two of these guys. Holy shit. They're just throwing a mountain of these things at me. Oh no, I'm not gonna play your games, robot. Like, look at all those things, holy crap. Okay, so what's up here? Is this just like, oh. Alright, just some score. I'm gonna try it over to the right one more time. Anything on a jump? No. Alright, well. I mean, we've picked up an extra life, and we are at 48 Vidalin towards another one. So, we have certainly been in worse places. We might be able to hit the fabled double-digit extra lives here. I don't know. What in the heck is... No, I didn't mean to do that. What is this thing up here? Alright, just some... background decor. I wonder if that's like a chute that we're gonna get dropped out of or something. Regardless, I am saving. Okay, we got a murder bot. We have another murder bot. I don't know what to call these things. Like, they're not murdery enough to be murder bots, but everything kills Keen in one hit because he is a feeble little... I don't even know. Okay, then. Let's, oh, I hate that. What's that thing on the right, under the little gun-looking thing? Can't tell. I can't tell if that's a pickup or not, is it? I don't know, I'm not gonna risk it. We're just gonna get the hell out of here. I'm digging the music, I do have to say. Okay, so whatever was under that other thing is what's right up there. I have no idea what that is. We're gonna save, and I'm going to see about grabbing it, though. I wonder, can I, like... No, alright. I think that was worth, like, 5,000 points, maybe, if that. So, not worth. I can probably check the instructions and figure out what it is. Looks like fucking a bowl of cereal surrounded by milk, if I had to guess. Sugar Stoopies! Alright. Okay. I'm curious. Oh, the keg of Vitalin. That keg that we saw, that's an extra keen in this one. Okay. Alright. Fair enough. Sugar Stoopies surrounded by marshmallows. Delicious Oh, this is fucking shit right here. I hate this. Those Sugar Stoopies are gonna stay right the fuck there, I can tell you all that. Keen. Alright, what's over here? Oh, if we stand up, it kills us, apparently. Oh, I wanna- ooh, I would like to get over there if at all possible. I don't know if it is. Did I save before I went in here? I did, okay. So yeah, I'm just gonna catch this and- oh, there we go! Oh, it totally was a little dropper thing called that. Nice! I'll take it. Bunch of ammo. Freaking 30 bullets. We are sitting good right now. 45 shots for our little phaser gun and 8 extra keens. This is certainly acceptable to me. The Sugar Stoopies can get fucked. I'm not even. We're so far away. It's what, 320,000 points. I'm sorry, but 10,000 is just not. You ain't selling me on that game. Okay, so that's a death trap. Oh, that is like such fucking shit. Oh my god. Maximum petulance. Oh, did I get these things? I did. Okay. I saved after coming back. Give me this. Man, you guys want a blast from the past. These little dudes that jump and explode remind me of this old ass, I think it was like, it wasn't a DOS game, it was like maybe early Windows. I probably played it on like, probably XP or something. It was like this top-down shooter maker almost. And like, you could import, I think, your own graphics and stuff into it, and like, they had like a bunch of guns and stuff, and what you would do to like make new enemies or whatever is you would take like a base thing, so you could have like a human or a vehicle or whatever, and then you would attach guns on it, and the game would just kind of make it work AI-wise. And, oh man, I had such a blast with it, and I can't remember what it was called. Oh, do we have to shoot this? I don't know what is expected of me unless we have to go above. I'm gonna save. But yeah, like, it was just a lot of fun. Okay, so this is... okay, yeah, we can't shoot it down here. So I assume then that we have to jump. Oh, very carefully. Do I have to shoot? No. Oh, okay. I have no fucking idea what I'm supposed to do here. I'm very thankful though that like the little these things don't hurt me. There's a sign back there, and I'm sure it's telling me, like, don't be an asshole and jump on these things. Oh, wait a minute. I was gonna say, don't be an asshole and jump on these things, and then the idea of doing so with my pogo stick came to me. Ooh, one of the four machines protecting the main elevator shaft is toast. Thumbs up. Returns. Alright. I wanna get a drink. Delicious water. Life-giving nectar of the gods. Okay, but yeah, like, there are a couple older games from my childhood, The Defense Tunnel Sora, that I remember playing, that I'll be asked if I could find them again. There was another that was a roguelike called, I believe, Hero, and I found it again once, but I've not been able to find it again since, and I stupidly did not save it the last time I found it, but it was another, like moderately graphical. It was like graphical tiles. And I always thought it was pretty... Oh, that was stupid. I thought that was a platform. Apparently not. But I always got a kick out of that. It wasn't, like, a particularly good roguelike. It was fairly straightforward. But I don't know. It's another... I think that's probably one of the first games I ever remember... I wouldn't call it modding, but really going at... Because you could crack your saves open, like they were plain text. They weren't saved as a plain text file. They had like, you know, like a .sav extension or whatever, but it was a plain text file if you actually opened it in like, oh my god. If you actually opened it in Notepad or whatever. And so of course, a young Gene had to go modifying his character stats and creating like these mega monsters. It was great. But yeah, that was a different time. That was like the Wild West of freeware. Can I kill these dudes? Oh! Okay. Seriously? They come back, but they don't give any indication that they're going to come back. Or is it just that if I approach it? Well, now we have to do science. Shoot it, get near it. Nope. They just come back eventually. That's kind of a shame because they've done that with enemies before and they would like wiggle before they actually came back. I'm like, I'm fine with that. I'm totally okay with enemies that, you know, we can't kill, but at least give me some indication that they're gonna come back and eat my fucking face off. Okay, so that is a trap for my greed. We'll pass on. I'm sure we could probably get it. We just need to ledge jump instead of, like, or not ledge jump, pull ourselves up the ledge instead of trying to leap out. But I think I'm gonna play it safe and we'll just avoid it because that's not enough points to really do a whole heck of a lot. I know there's one of you. God, this is like. I don't know. A lot of it's the. Oh, alright. A lot of it's the limited viewport. And, like, it makes things harder. And I'm sure when we get to Duke Nukem, like Duke Nukem 2, I'm gonna be raging because I remember the viewport in that game being incredibly tiny. Like for all the shit that's going on, but it is what it is. And then it'll be, I think, onto Jill of the Jungle after that. Ooh, I'll wait. I'm in no hurry. Okay. My own fault. Man, the saves and loading. It's getting a workout here. It's kinda... Oh, you guys. Oh, you guys. That's terrible. Oh! 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 I'm saving again. I kind of wish the game had a quick save, quick load of any sort. Just to kind of make this stuff a little quicker. That's okay. Oh, damn it. I hit end game again. Ah! One button too far. Okay, we're back in. I was gonna say. God, that is some bullshit! But they did kind of hint at it, so I can't complain over much. My question is now, how far is this thing's patrol? Wow, okay. That little robot down there charging at me is adorable. Anything down here? Some guns. I'll take them. And then I'm going to engage in maximum wuss. Ah, oh, man, they're getting moderately cruel. I like it. Okay, so we have the yellow one, so we can open this. I'm not even mad. Oh, I would have been mad if I just saved there, though. Ooh. this fucking game. That's pretty. That is like so fucking cruel. Secret. Nothing. All right. Get the fuck out of here. That was a good one though. All right. Well, that's two levels down, and we're at 15 minutes. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope y'all had a good time, and I will see you next time when the adventure continues. Until then.